these days, but now it's just during the January sales. Chester has some of the oldest shop fronts in the world, and in the 13th century, Chester was the second most important port in the country. This wall was built by the Romans. It was some feet. It's been excavated another 15 feet further down. I'm sure even modern day builders would be proud of such a construction. Why build a wall here? Well, amazingly, this used to be the port of Chester, and the racecourse was the basin. But since Roman times, it has silted up and the course of the river has changed. I've researched Chester's history, and there's just so much of it, it deserves a programme of its own. So don't just ride through the city, take some time to stop off, because there's so much to see and do. This is the station for Willesden. It closed in 1952, a year before my bicycle was built. It was owned by the Cheshire Lines Company. The odd thing about it was they had their own rolling stock, but no locomotives. It's called Hadlow Road because there was another station at Crewe called Willesden. And nowadays it's just a cycleway, a bridleway and a footpath. I'm hoping to see the D soon. It's been one of my high points, waiting to see the sea. Is it far from here?
Oh, it's just over there. It's not far at all.
Oh.
You'll see the D, you'll see the grass first, but then you'll see the D on the other side of it. Of course, it's disappeared over the years, but it's a wonderful view over there, over to the Welsh Mountains.
All right. Can you see the sea the other side as well on this Wirral Peninsula?
Yes, you can. At the very tip of the peninsula, when you get up to the West Kirby, obviously,
oh, I see.
Area. But at the moment, you'll have a really good view of the D over there, definitely.
Right. So we're going out on a finger, aren't we, here?
That's exactly, yes, that's it. The Wirral Peninsula, as it's known, is quite famous with the two, the Dee and the Mersey on both sides of it. Very good.
So this is Park Gate. Just 100 years ago, it would have been a very different scene. This would be clean yellow sands. But since about 1400, the Dee has been silting up. But now it's a great site for birdwatchers. One of the many things that Park Gate is famous for is its award-winning ice cream. Another interesting fact about Park Gate is that Handel actually spent some time here, just putting the finishing touches to the Messiah in 1741, while he waited for a boat to take him over to Ireland. Well, we've made it, me and my trusty steed. Now, I hope you've enjoyed the ride as much as I have. It's great to do just part of the ride, or maybe even the whole thing. Hope to see you out on the road sometime. The ride is ideal for a short break, and there are plenty of lovely places to stay and eat along the route. Cheshire is also famous for its historic houses and gardens, which are well worth visiting. You can find out more information by visiting www.cheshire.gov.uk.